Hey guys, in this video we're going to look at two examples of finding values and functions. The first example is f of x equals 2x plus 9, and we are instructed to find the value of f of 3. And all this means is we're going to substitute negative 3 for x in the expression 2x plus 9. So f of negative 3 means what happens when you plug in negative 3 for x in the function expression. So we're going to plug that in and put that in parentheses, and then all we have to do is simplify the terms in the expression now. So you would multiply 2 times negative 3 to get negative 6 plus 9, and then you would add the negative 6 plus 9. Those are opposite signs, so that's going to give you a positive 3. So f of negative 3 in this function gives you a positive 3 as a value. Now let's look at the second function, f of x equals negative 3x squared plus 3x plus 4. And this time we want to find the value of negative 5. This one's a little bit more involved. You just have to make sure you watch what happens when you plug in that negative 5. We are going to start by substituting negative 5 for x in the expression, and then we're going to simplify the terms, just like we did in the first example. But this time, when you plug in that negative 5, make sure you just plug it in for the x, the variable, and not don't do anything else with it when you plug it in. So we're going to put parentheses around it, and that's going to give us a negative 3 with the parentheses negative 5 raised to the second power, and then plus your 3 times negative 5, and then plus 4. So what we're going to focus on now is just focusing on that negative 5 and what we have to do with it. In the first term, the negative 5 is squared, and in the second term, it's multiplied by 3. So we're just going to touch those two things. That's going to give us a negative 3 times 25, which is negative 5 squared, then plus a negative 15, which is 3 times negative 5, and then plus 4. The next thing we're going to do is look at that negative 3 times 25, and that's going to give us a negative 75, plus that negative 15, and then plus a 4. Finally, we're going to take a look at those two negative terms, that negative 75 and negative 15, add those together, and that gives you a negative 90 plus 4. And now we can finally do negative 90 plus 4, and that gives us a negative 86 for a final answer on that one. So on expressions like the second one, you do have to be careful when you're squaring a negative. Make sure you just square the value that you plug in and not anything else. I'm going to give you two more examples just to practice with if you'd like. I'm going to give you a blank screen on those and ask you to go ahead and pause the video and you can work on these and you can check them in just a second. All right, we're back now and I'm going to give you the answers on these so you can check them. The work is there, and if you need to pause again to check your work, you can. And otherwise, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you.